Hello and welcome to our presentation on workflow fundamentals. I will begin by identifying the RIPQ workspace, demonstrate methods for ripping files, identify folder structure, explore job editor, and give an overview of quicksets. Let's begin by identifying the RIPQ. First, at the very top, I have pull-down menus with options that may also be present in the main application area. One important section I want to show you is in the Help pull-down menu about Thrive RIPQ. Here I can see what the key number is and the version of RIP software. This is important information if you are looking to upgrade or if you are calling into support with a question. Also, the Help menu can be accessed. Here I can search or view the index and obtain details on features within the RIP software. In the application area, I can launch software by double-clicking on the feature. For example, I can double-click on Job Editor and launch that software. Just below the application area is a list of printers that are installed and configured for the RIP. I have a Canon printer with this media type loaded, roll size, and other details in this list. As I select the printer on the far right side, I will see printer-specific information. I can see the media type, roll size, percentage full, and job placement strategy. In this case, I have chosen conserve media, which is a manual start print method. The jobs in the print queue will be sent to the printer when I select print now. In the print preview, I can see thumbnails of my jobs, and if I hover over, I will see the job name appear. In the lower right corner, I have a console area which will display processing commands. The next area below the printer's list is the jobs ready to print, and this shows the jobs in the RIP queue. I can see the job name, status, printer that this job was ripped for, media size, and job ticketing information. When I select the job on the far right side, I see job-specific information as well as a preview. If I need to make changes to the job, for example, number of copies, I can select the job and on the far right side, select Change. This opens the job properties. I can set the number of copies, and then I can select OK. In my list, this reflects the number of copies I've entered for that job. I can also double-click on the job to open job properties, or I can right-click and access job properties. In job properties, there are many controls to adjust our settings if we need to. While a job is selected, I can open into Job Editor. Here I can make changes to the job with more control than in job properties. I can set the tile panels or configure for step and repeats for textile printing, or perform a color replacement. Once I have completed edits to the job, I can submit this to the RIP, and now I can print this job. On the left side of the jobs ready to print list, I have controls to modify the job. I can make modifications to the job in respect to list order. I can select the job and move it up or down or to top or to bottom. I can make a copy of the job to go to another printer. I can select the job and delete it from the RIP queue by selecting the red circle with the white X. I can place a job on hold, which will temporarily remove it from being printed. The job will still be in the job list with a hold status. I can take it off of hold by selecting the job and clicking on hold again. If I place a job on hold, then select my printer and click print now, all the jobs with waiting to print statuses will be released to the printer. The job on hold will not print until I take it off of hold and select print now. All of these settings and more can be accessed by right-clicking on a job. At the very bottom of the RIPQ is a list of buffered jobs. These are jobs that have been printed or have been set to archive. Now let's go through the different methods for submitting files to the RIP. One method is within our RIPQ. In the upper left corner, I can select Open and browse for a file to RIP. In addition to bringing a file into the RIP, we can control some basic parameters for how the file will process by using quick sets. Quick sets are the settings by which the job will be ripped. Quick sets can be configured for a specific media type or cutter, for number of copies, and much more. I will select the default quick set. Just below this, I have data fields that I can enter in job ticket information. This can be informative and is a searchable entry in our jobs ready to print list. I can also conveniently set rotation here. I can check on Open in Job Editor, which would bring the job into Job Editor first, allowing me to make any changes necessary to the job. Then I would submit this to the RIPQ to begin processing. So the first method of submitting a file to the RIP is within the RIPQ with the Open command. Browse for a file, choose the quick set, enter in any job ticket information as needed, then open and bring into the RIP. Now I can see the job in the RIP and the console is active with messaging that's processing the file. Once it is complete, I can see the preview of the job as I have selected it. The second method to submit files to the RIP is through the use of hot folders. Hot folders are quick sets, which are the parameters for how our job will print. Let's take a brief look at a quick set. I will select Edit Quick Sets from the top menu. I will select Backlit Film and Edit. In this list, there are a variety of options to control how the file will process. I can select Advanced and see more options. In this quick set, I am choosing the condition for a specific media type, which is durable backlit film, normal quality. Jobs that are ripped using this quick set will only print if this media is set to the printer as the current media. Quick sets are designed to streamline the process by applying specific settings to the jobs during ripping. This will eliminate the need to go to Job Editor and make those settings apply manually. Many quick sets can be created based on ripping needs. When a quick set is created, a hot folder is automatically generated. Let's take a look at where those hot folders reside and how we can submit files using these hot folders. In the Thrive 11 folder structure, where the software is located, there is a folder identified as Input. Inside this folder are subfolders identified as the printer models that are installed and configured to the RIP. Inside a specific printer folder, I can see the hot folders or quick sets. Notice the names match the names that are in my quick set list at the RIP. To rip a file using a hot folder, I simply drag and drop or copy and paste the job I want to rip into the appropriate hot folder. Once this begins to process, the job is moved from the hot folder and brought into the RIP. Now when I return to the RIP queue, I can see the job here ripping. These hot folders can be set up as shares and accessed across the network so that the production department from a Macintosh or PC can submit files directly to the hot folders, therefore engaging in file submission in a similar method as the open and choosing that quick set method. So that is our second method for submitting files to the RIP through the use of hot folders. Now let's take a look at a third method for sending files to the RIP. This is through Production Manager, which is a web portal. By opening a web browser on a Macintosh or PC, I can access the Production Manager software. To do so, I will enter in the URL field the IP address of the RIP, followed by a colon, and then the port number, which is typically 80. Let me show you where to find the port number in the RIP software. In the RIP, I will select File, General, Settings. Here I can see the web portal feature, which is checked on and active, and the number is set to 80. Enable Production Manager. I will return to the web browser and see the Production Manager software. I can submit files by selecting Submit New Job in the upper right corner. I can browse for a file I want to rip, select my printer, select the quick set, any rotation or job ticketing information, and more. Once I select Submit, the file will be added to the RIP queue. There are controls here to view jobs that are active or inactive, which represents buffer jobs or filters to control in the queue. I can select the job and make adjustments to settings if needed. If I select the Devices tab, I can see the printer, media loaded, and status. In the Log tab, I can see a list of the jobs that have been printed. This is part of our Connect software package, which allows information to be accessed and managed internally. To review, there are three main methods for submitting files to the RIP. While in the RIP software, select Open. By dragging and dropping or copying and pasting a file to the appropriate hot folder, and through the use of Production Manager via a web portal. So we can see in a production environment on a Macintosh or PC computer, we are able to engage in submitting files to the RIP. When we are in the RIP software, the open choice to rip a file may be the method by which the main RIP operator would use. However, remotely from the desktop applications, from a Macintosh or a PC, the hot folder or web portal methods may be used to send files to the RIP. Now let's take a look at opening a job in Job Editor. In the RIP, I will open a file and check on the feature Open in Job Editor. I will make a quick set choice of default and bring this file into the RIP and open in Job Editor. The purpose of Job Editor is to make any last minute changes to the job as needed. The first tab is Printer and Media. I can change media or input profiles referenced. I can also activate a cutter if the file has been prepared for cutting data. The next tab is Preview and Size. The job can be sized proportionally, or by clicking on the link symbol, I can enter in disproportional values. The file can be rotated, mirrored, or cropped. In the Patterns tab, controls features for our step and repeats and to enable colorways. In step and repeat, the horizontal and vertical repeats and offset or positions can be controlled. In colorways, different color libraries can be applied to the file for multiple version outputs. In the Tiling Setup tab, I could enable tiling on and set the size for individual tile panels. I can either drag the guides over or enter in a specific width. In the Color Correction tab, there are settings to change color balance, saturation, contrast, brightness, white and black limits. An eyedropper can be used to see the values change. This is also where color placements can be performed. Spot Layer Tool is a quick method to generate a flood fill of white or to select objects and set as white. This is used in place of designing the file for white. And in turn, these settings can be saved as a filter and applied in a quick set to automate this process, thus eliminating the need to manually make this change in Job Editor. For more information on how to save a filter, please visit our website, log into your Myonix account, and go to the document page for a step-by-step procedure. In the Print tab, I can indicate number of copies, enter in job ticket data fields, place a job on hold, and in Print Setup, additional changes can be made, such as enabling sewing marks. Tiling Setup allows for selection of specific tiles to be output. Now I will submit the job to be ripped based on any changes I have made in Job Editor. This will leave the process of Job Editor and be brought into the RIP queue. I can see the RIP queue process and status update. So Job Editor allows us to make any last minute changes to the job before sending to the RIP. Now let's say you need to take a buffer job, which is a job that has been printed, and resubmit that for printing. To do this, to reprint a job that has already been printed, I will simply select a job in the buffered list and drag it back up to the jobs ready to print queue. A message appears asking if I want to reprocess the job before printing. This means re-ripping. If you just want to reprint the job as before, then answer no. If you have recalibrated since the previous output and want to incorporate that algorithm, then answer yes. Now I can see the job is reinstated into the list and is waiting to print. Now I can select my printer and on the far right side, select Print Now and release the jobs to the printer. When these jobs have been printed, they will reside in the buffered jobs area below. This will conclude our presentation on workflow fundamentals. For more information about Onyx products, please visit our website at onyxgfx.com.